टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव लेक्चर एंड डिस्कशन ऑन द परफॉर्मेंस प्लानिंग हाउ द परफॉर्मेंस प्लानिंग इज मेड इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एज डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट इज इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड द ग्रोथ एंड सर्वाइवल ऑफ द एनी ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट. टुडे वी डिस्कस what are the objectives are there, what are the characteristics of the performance planning is there, what are objectives of the performance planning is there, what is importance of the performance planning is there, what are methodology of the performance planning is there, what is the process of the performance planning is there, what are barriers to the performance planning is there, and the summary, keywords, self-assessment, review questions, further readings. These will be discussed by the today. After studying this unit, you will be able to state the characteristics and objectives of the performance planning, explain the importance and methodology of the performance planning, state the process and barriers to the performance planning. The performance planning part of the performance management sequence is primary a joint exploration of the what individual need to do and know to improve their performance and develop their skill and competency. To know the performance and develop the competency, it is essential. The performance planning is essential. How their managers can provide the support and guidance they need. This requires competence mapping and machine and potential development. The performance aspect of the plan obtained agreement on what has to do on achieve the objective, the raise the standard and improve the performance. It also establishes priority, the key aspects of the job to which the attention has to be given. Agreement is also reached at this stage on the basis upon which the performance will be measured and the evidence that will be used to establish the level of the competence. It is important that these measures and evidence requirement should be identified and fully agreed now, because they will be used jointly by the managers and individuals and collectively by the teams of the monitors progress and demonstrate the achievements. During the performance planning phase, you will be prepared for the performance planning session by reviewing the department mission statement, goals, objective, and strategy, and by drafting a preliminary set of the development research performance objective or the job responsibility. Give the researcher ample notice of the performance planning session, review the overall purpose and design of the performance management system. Share the relevant department material and ask the development researcher to draft the preliminary performance objective or the job responsibility. Characteristics of the performance planning. The given below are the key characteristics of the performance planning. Performance planning is the key essential for effective performance management system. Performance planning is a continuous process which starts with understanding of the organizational objective and ends with the setting of the performance criteria. It is a continuous process which starts with the understanding of the organizational objectives. पहले ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का जो ऑब्जेक्टिव्स है, मिशंस है, गोल को आप समझिए, then setting the performance criteria. Performance planning helps in attaining the goals and objective of the organization. What are the goals and the objective of the organization? Performance planning motivate the employee to contribute their best in achieving the key goal of the organization. Motivate the employee. Performance planning is an integral part of the performance management system. It is an integral part of the performance management system. Performance planning identifies the criteria for assessing the employee performance. What is the employee performance? This will be judged by the performance planning. All the criteria of the employee performance will be judged by the performance planning. Performance planning helps in the setting the basis for the making distinguish between the different level of the performance. Performance planning helps in deciding the criteria for rewarding the employee as per the achievement. Deciding the criteria for rewarding the employee as per their achievement. What are the objectives of the performance planning? The development of an employee performance management plan is paramount to the success of the any performance management system. A performance plan establishes the development, research, essential job task, responsibility, and critical performance objective that need to be achieved or performed during the performance period. The performance plan is mutually developing during the planning conference and reflects the individual aspects of the nature of the employee job. The key objective of the performance planning are given below. Performance planning clearly defines the purpose of the organization. What is the purpose of the organization? What are the objectives of the organization? What are the missions of the organization? It clearly defines and to establish their realistic goals and objective consistent with the mission in a defined time frame within the organization's capacity for the implementation. Communicate those goals and objectives to the organization's constituents. What are the goals? Communicate the goals to the organization constituent. Ensure the most effective use is made of the organization's resources by focusing the resources on the key priority. Ensure the most effective use is made of the organization resources by focusing the resources on the key priority. Provide a base from which the progress can be measured and establish a mechanism for the informed change when they need it. It establishes a mechanism for the informed change when needed. It listens to the everyone's opinion in order to the build the consensus about where the organization is going on. It provides the clear focus for the organization. Clear focus for the organization, where the organization has to be work, and thereby producing more efficiency and the effectiveness. Efficiency and effectiveness is necessary for the any of the organization. To clear the identify the performance matrices used to measure the employee success in meeting the predetermined target. Produces great satisfaction and meaning among the planner, especially around a common vision, increases productivity from increased efficiency and effectiveness. It increases the productivity from increased efficiency and effectiveness, solves major problems in the organization to provide an ongoing on the job feedback. Best practice identify the objective are easily understood and acted upon when they are specific, measurable, and achievable, and realistic, and the time is specific. The acronym SMART is an aid to remember those component. To set the SMART objective, it is important to identify the outcome expected, the what. Provide indicators to measure the degree of the achievement. Create an objective that constitutes a challenge within the staff member's capability. Take into account available resources and include a target date or the response time. Include a target date and the response time. Importance of the performance planning. Coaches work with the performance plan or work plans to keep their employee motivated. They operate with such plan in place or each and every one of their team members. The following point discusses the importance of the performance planning. Performance planning helps in aligning the individual goal with the organizational goal. What is the individual goals are there? And that is to be aligned with the organizational goals. Aligning of the every person's goal in the organizational goal. This is important to achieve the organization goal. Performance planning makes the process of the performance management more accountable and objectives. Performance planning focuses on the key results area and the key performance area. What are the key result areas are there? Results is to be identified. And what are the performance area that is to be identified? This is the importance of the performance plan. Performance planning helps in the maximum utilization of the resources. How the resources can be utilized? How the maximum utilization of the resources, every manager has to be think in the plan that the how the you can utilize the maximum resources, and planning helps in the maximum utilization of the resources. Performance planning is important to take clarity in the role and responsibility of the employee. It is important to make clarity in the role and responsibility of employee. What are the role and responsibility of the employee are there? That is to be clear. In the role and responsibility of employee, what are the role of the employee and what are the responsibility of employee? That is to be clear. Methodology for the performance planning. The key methodology of setting a performance criteria are as follows. Key performance area. What are the key performance area are there? What are the key results area are there? What are the key results area are there? Task and target identification. What are the task and target identification there? Goal setting exercises. What are the goal setting exercises? Goal setting exercises are there. Organizational objective and strategy. What are the organizational objectives and strategy are there? Assessment of the organizational performance needs. What are the organizational performance needs are there? Setting or organizational performance expectation. What are the organizational performance expectations are there? Establishing the performance management process. Measuring effective of the performance management. Effective of the performance management. Key performance area includes the identification of the priority area to an employee and subsequent working on the specified area. The process of the key performance area involves the following step. Identification of the important task and activity. What are the important tasks are there in the organization? Identify there. What are the important tasks are there? What are the activities are there? Determining the area of the priority. What are the different area of the priority are there? Setting goals in the identified area. What are the goals are there in the identified area? Seeking the employee's commitment for the identified work. Employee's commitment for the identified work. What are the employee's commitment are there? Making arrangements for the required resources. This is important. Make arrangements for the required resources are there. What are the required resources for the organization? What are the key result area is there? The term key result area may be defined as a general area of the outcome for which a role is responsible. Identify KR helps individual employee in a number of ways as enumerated here. Clarify their roles. What are the roles are there? Align their roles to the organization business or the strategic plan. Focus on the results rather than activity. Focus on the results. Results are coming or not, focus on the results. Results are coming or not, you have to focus on the results rather than activity. You have to get the best optimum results, that is the important in the any of the organization. Communicate their roles purposes to the others. What are the roles purposes are there to the others that have to be communicated? Set goals and objective. Set the goals and objective. What are the goals are there? What are objectives are there? That is to be set. Priority their activity and therefore improve their time work management. Improve the time work management. make evaluated decision. Key result area capture to about 80% of your work role. The remainder of the role is usually devoted to area of the shared responsibility. Image of the organization is usually a very senior level officials key result area, but hopefully all employee contribute to this outcome. Key result area are worded using few terms as possible with the no verb, that is about results, not action and not direction measurement. They simply describe the area for which one is responsible for the results. Individuals undertake the following step to determine the KRA for their roles. Enlist main day-to-day responsibility activity. For each activity, ask, why do I do this? Enlist main day-to-day responsibility and activity. Day-to-day responsibility and activity are important for any of the person. Day-to-day responsibility, day-to-day activity, what they are doing. Review the answer. Why courses looking for the common themes or the area? Identify the KRA from these themes. Individuals undertake the following step to determine the KRA for their roles. These are the main themes are there. Share KRA preferably those they report to, those they work along with, and with those who report to them. The KRO approach has the three main advantage. It has the three main advantage are there, such as innovation. Innovation is essential. There are many types of the innovations are there. Product innovation is there, process innovation is there, organization innovation is there. Innovation is important for the every year. Customer response time is important. Customer, how the customer responses, this is an important. Employee development are included. Rather than being overlooked. Employee should be developed. What the employee is doing, what the employee is to be doing, that is to be overlooked. It is the first stage of the objective setting. It is the first step of the objective setting. It makes it easier to assess current performance. Task and target identification involves the identification of the role, responsibility, task, and key targets of the employee. Each and every employee should know their duty and the key target. Every employee of the organization should know their duty. What are his duties there? What are the key targets are there for the everyday goal setting? It is important. Goal setting exercise, a organization's ultimate goal determines its strategy. An organization intending to become the world's largest textile company in the shortest possible time, ultimate goal, will increase its production capacity either through the organic route, such as setting up the new manufacturing facility, or by acquiring other textile organizations. Since acquisition helps increasing the production capacity quickly, the organization shall pursue acquisition as a strategy for the faster growth. But acquisition strategy also involves turning around the performance of the older acquired production unit, which essentially calls for improving human performance for the corporate success. Organizational objective and strategy. Organization's ultimate goal. What are the ultimate goal and mission of the organization is there? Set the goal, set the objective. Organization's competitive position. What are the competitive positions of the organization is there? Comparing organization's strength and the changing environment. What are the organizations are the strength are there? What are the changing environment is there? Examining organizations critical issues. What are the critical issues are there in the organization? Analyzing organizations opportunity. What are the organizations opportunity is there? Exploring best approach in view of the organizational resources and the competence. What are the organizational resources are there and competency is there? Assessment of the organizational performance needs. Identifying the competency necessary for achieving the organizational objective and strategy. Gathering information about the critical issues. What are the critical issues are there? Determining new and future performance need. What are the new and future performance needs are there for tracking the organizational improvement measures. Recognizing core organizational value. What are the organizational value is there? Recognize the core organizational value. This is the assessment of the organizational performance need, setting of the organizational performance expectation, determining the required and desired performance, determining the current performance status, understanding, aligning, and agreeing on the performance expectation, formulating the key performance indicators. Evaluating the job objectives. Aligning the individual goals with the organizational strategy, establishing performance management process, designing a framework of the performance management, encompassing performance planning, performance managing, performance appraisal, performance monitoring. These are the process. Performance planning, then manage the performance managing, then appraisal, then monitoring. These are the performance management process. Measuring the effectiveness of the performance management. Identifying the opportunity for the performance development. Providing performance counseling including 360 degree feedback. Devising reward strategy and administrating reward system. Instituting performance management audit. How the measuring the performance management will be there. Counseling including the 360 degree feedback. Reward strategy and administrating the reward system. Instituting performance management audit. What are the performance management audit is there? Improvement in the competitive position of the organization. Competitive position of the organization is the improved or not. Identifying opportunity for the performance development. For the performance development, opportunity has to be identified. Providing the performance counseling, including the 360 degree feedback. 360 degree feedback is important for the organization's development. Process of the performance planning, there are the many advantages to the boss, supervisor, and employee in having an effective performance planning and the review process. The process should identify clearly what is expected of the employee, which in turn provides the opportunity to recognize good performance and identify area that need corrective action or edit training. Four area that must to be identified in the performance plan are the job responsibility. What has to be done? Every employee must have their job responsibility. Performance measure. How will this be checked or measured? What are the performance measure is there? Performance standard. How will must be done? What are the performance standard is there? By the benchmarking, you can establish the standard that you have to be go there. Target date. When it will be checked? When it will be checked? When building a performance plan, you would obtain information in this area from the job description, and you would also look to the organization needs to clarify which duty have been priority and the standard they must be performed to. An effective performance plan should outline results expected, performance measure, standards to be achieved, and target date for the measurement. The following are the key components of the performance planning. Preparation of the performance plan. Performance plan are usually prepared at the beginning of the annual review period or when an employee first starts their new job. Preparing for the initial planning meeting should be undertaken by both the supervisor and the employee. Both supervisor and employee should be reviewing the goals, objective and needs of the work unit and looking at the current job description. The supervisor should list the things in the job that they intend to measure and understand you will measure to. The employee could write down the ways they think each of their tasks could be measured and how well it should be performed. Identification of the key success factors, performance objective and results to be achieved should be focused on the results and set in the order priority. Measures should be specific to the each task with the clear standard and include dates and times when appropriate. Setting the departmental and individual objectives. After setting the organizational goals and the objectives of the department, goals and objective are defined. The departmental objective are further categorized into the individual goals. The individual goals include the key duty and responsibility to achieve the final goals of the organization. Final goals of the organization. Providing the regular feedback. The next step in the process is the providing the regular feedback. The supervisor should be maintaining a log of the performance fact, which will ensure that the important issues are given the attention that is required and will help the formal review process in a more focused and potentially more positive way. The employee should also maintain a record of the accomplishment and a specific achievement or issue that need to be resolved. Discussion of these things during the scheduled or spontaneous feedback session will allow resolution of the problem in a timely manner. Performance review. Reviewing the performance gives the supervisor and the employee the opportunity to look at the results that have been achieved in relation to the original plan and standard of the performance that were established. At this meeting, you should review all performance record and assess each task, discussing whether they meet the standards of the performance or not and whether they exceed those standards. Review any outside factor that may have an effect of the performance. At this time, the supervisor should be identifying any area where the improvement may be necessary or performance could be enhanced. The employee should also have the opportunity to discuss area where they could have used more help. Action planning. Another important aspect of the completing this cycle is the action planning. This is the way the supervisor and employee would plan for any training that needs to occur and could also be where you discuss career plan. Make a discussion and performance planning in the IHR Motors Limited. In the every company, the performance planning will be discussed. What will be the performance planning of a specific organization that is to be discussed? Barrier to the performance planning. What are the barriers to the performance planning? The barriers to the performance planning can be categorized as follows. Organizational barriers. Most of the traditional organizations are not in favor of the performance planning. According to these organization, spending time on the performance planning is just the wastage of the time. These organizations believe that they have a strong implementation strategy. Example, Indian company tend to spend 30% time on the planning and remaining 70% on the implementation. Where MNC usually spend 70% time on the performance planning and 30% time on the strategy implementation. This is the difference between the Indian company and the MNC. Why the MNC are going to be successful? They have the strong performance planning. They have the strong performance planning of the multinational companies are there. Hence, they are great successful. Individual barriers. Lack of the commitment in the organization, employee or management is another important barrier to the performance plan. Lack of the commitment in the organization's employee. Lack of the commitment in the organization's employee are the barriers. Hence, for all the employee, a written document must be taken to remove this barrier, that what type of the plan will be done by the employee, barrier to the performance plan. Sometimes managers or the employee are both so less commitment towards the achievement of the organization goals. Managers are the employee, so the less commitment towards the achievement of the organization goals. Hence, this barrier is to be removed by the taking the written document with the employee. The reason should be personal, organizational and competitive, or any other HR factor. Organizational politics, workplace bullying, or high conflict causes employee to show less interest towards their job responsibility. High conflict causes implied to show less interest toward the job responsibility. These are the barriers. New software to improve Paris Council's planning. We will discuss the Paris City Council's objective has to effectively produce a strategic and management plan along with the detailed project and activity plan as well as associated reporting. The council required online reporting to replace its current hard copy reporting, and there was a strong desire by the council to provide staff with the improved user experience and to increase productivity and skills in both planning and the performance reporting. Tenders were called to replace the incumbent system in 2002. Four complaint tenders were received, and after a rigorous evaluation process, Outcome Manager Technology One's performance planning solution was selected. This performance planning solution was deemed to be the most efficient and effective tool and deliver the most flexibility for the council. The council recognized the system's ability to produce the real productivity and transparency benefits by enabling tasks to be assigned, delegated, reassigned, or shifted to the different levels, as well as enabling people on leave to the temporarily assigned items. Pandit City Council believed that a performance planning solution would enhance functionality in area what were underdeveloped, such as a cross-functional planning, project evaluation, and both financial and the capacity planning. At a grassroots level, there is the desire to provide employees with a greater understanding of their roles within the strategic and management plan framework, and to demonstrate that the council is efficient and effective within the government as well as being customer focused. Integration and ease of use were the key decision factor. Council saw this solution as the best choice because it could be deployed via the web browser, enabling the system to fit the seamlessly with both the internet, which means that staff working remotely could maintain access. Its flexibility and ability to adapt the council's needs, along with compatibility with the council Microsoft SQL Server platform, were also integral to the selection process. council had a strong planning framework and reporting procedure. But until we implemented a performance planning solution, we lacked the system to bring it all the together. Ross Kingsley, Corporate Development Management, Tandit City Council. Summary, the performance planning part of the performance management sequence is a primarily joint exploration of what individuals need to do and know to improve their performance and develop their skills and competency, and how their manager can provide the support and guidance they need. The performance aspect of the plan obtained agreement on what has to be done on the achieve objective, raise the standard, and improve performance. Performance planning is the key essential for the effective performance management system. Coaches work with the performance plan or work plan to keep their employee motivated. Key performance area includes the identification of the priority area to an employee and subsequent working on the specified area. The term key results area may be defined as general area of the outcome for which a role is responsible. The process of the performance planning should identify clearly what is expected of the employee, which in turn provides the opportunity to recognize good performance and identify area that corrective action or aided training. Keywords, goal is there. The purpose toward which an endeavor is directed. Mission, it defines what an organization is, what it exists, and its reason for the being. Objective, something that one's efforts or action are intended to attain or accomplish. Performance, it is behavior and should be distinguished from the outcomes because they can be contaminated by the system factors. Vision, a statement giving a broad inspirational image of the future that an organization is aiming to achieve. The self-assessment question is given here. And the review questions are given here. What are the review questions are given here? Self-assessment questions are given here, and the further readings, references are given here. FBB Daniel. The references are given here. Hence, today we have discussed the summary of the performance planning, new software to improve the performance council planning. Software will be provide the help to the performance plan. Software will help the performance plan. Council is a strong planning framework and reporting procedure, but until we implemented a performance planning, should we lack the system to bring it all together. Barriers to the performance planning. Every manager have to look out the what are the barriers are there. You see here the difference between the Indian company and MNC company. MNC company, European company, Japanese company, I spend more time on the performance planning. Where the Indian company spend less time on the performance planning. Performance planning is essential for any of the organization. For any of the growth. Individual barriers, lack of the commitment in the organization's organizations employees are not committed about the organization goal. Or management is another important barrier to the performance planning. Sometimes manager or employee are both so less commitment toward the achievement of the organization goal. Managers and employee are less commitment to the organization goal. The reason should be personal, organizational, competitive, or any other HR factor. Organization politics are there. These are the barriers. Workplace bullying is there. High conflict causes to employee show less interest toward the job responsibility. These are the barriers which are discussed here, the most important thing here in the case of the performance planning. Then we discussed about the process of the performance planning. Job responsibility, performance measure, performance standard, and target value must to be checked. Preparation of the performance plan, identification of the key success factors, setting the department and individual objectives, providing regular feedback, performance review, and action planning. These are the process for the performance planning. Then we have discussed methodology of the performance planning. What are the different methodology of the performance planning? Set up the key performance area, key result area, task and target identification, goal setting exercises, organization objective and strategy, assessment of the organizational performance need, setting of the organizational performance expectation. What are the key performance area is there? What are the key results area are there? Task and target identification are the work goal setting exercises are there. What are the organizational objective and strategy are there? What are the organizational performance need is there? Establishing performance management process there. Measuring effectiveness of the performance management. What are the effectiveness of the performance management is there? We have discussed the importance of the performance planning. These are the five importance of the performance planning is there. Maximum utilization of the resources. Make clarity in the role and responsibility of the employee. Key result area, key performance area. Performance planning helps in aligning an individual goals with the organization goals. These are the importance of the performance plan. SMART objective, identify the outcome expected, what provide indicator to measure the degree of the achievement. Objectives of the performance planning, what are the different objectives of the performance planning have been discussed. Without the performance planning, any human, any organization cannot be sustained. What are the job tasks? What are the responsibility? What are the critical performance objective that need to be achieved or the performance during the performance period? The performance plan is usually developed during the planning conference and reflect the individual aspect and nature of the employee job. This is the objectives of the performance plan. What are the characteristics of the performance planning? The given below are the key characteristics of the performance planning. Performance planning is key essential for an effective performance management system. Performance planning is a continuous process which starts with the understanding of the organizational objective and it's with the setting of the performance criteria. Performance planning helps in attaining the goals and objective of the organization. Performance planning motivates the employee to contribute their best in achieving the key goal of the organization. Performance planning is an integral part of the performance management system. Performance planning identifies the criteria for assessing the employee's performance. These are the characteristics of the performance planning. Hence, in the case of the performance planning, we have discussed about the characteristics of the performance planning, objectives of the performance planning, importance of the performance planning, methodology of the performance planning, process of the process the performance planning, barriers to the performance planning. What are the summary? What are the keyword? What are the self-assessment? What are the review question? What are the further? These are the performance planning.